Hello children, today we are going to start a new lesson, how the dog found himself a new master. This is a folk story. What is a folk story? Folk tales are stories in the oral traditions that people pass on to the next generation. Folk stories generally don't have any authors. These stories are transferred to people generation by generation orally. Because of the hard work of the researchers, now many folk tales are available for reading. You all are familiar with the stories like Cinderella, Rapunzel, Sleeping Beauty, Snow White, and the Pied Piper. These all are example for folk tales. This chapter, how the dog found himself a new master, is also an interesting folk tale. This is a folk story written in old style. Before we enter into the lesson, we will write the hard word meanings first. Then take out your notebook now and write with me. Hard word meanings. One, ill pleased. Ill-pleased means not happy. Second one, frightened. FRIGHTENED. Frightened means afraid. Third one is kinsman means a relation. Here ill-pleased, kinsman, these type of words are old-fashioned way of saying. Then fourth one, wandering. Wandering means walking aimlessly. Fifth one, fierce. F-I-E-R-C-E. Fierce means violent, frightening. F-R-I-T-H-T-E-N-I-N-G. Island frightening. Number six, sniff. Sniff means a quick breath to smell something. A quick breath to smell something. Ill-pleased, not happy, frightened, afraid, kinsman, a relation, wandering, walking aimlessly, fierce, violent, frightening, sniff, a quick breath to smell something. Then next word, seventh one, dotted. Dotted means moved quickly. Eighth one, crept. Moved slowly. Crept, here creep. Crept. Crept is the past tense of creep. Ninth one, hastily. Hastily means urgently. Next one, beast. B-E-A-S-T. Beast means a large, dangerous animal. A large and dangerous animal. Next one, dare. D-A-R-E. Dare means brave. These are the meanings. Children, let us read the first two paragraph now. Lesson number two, how the dog found himself a new master. Dogs were once their own masters and lived the way wolves do in freedom until a dog was born who was ill-pleased with this way of life. He was sick and tired of wandering about by himself, looking for food and being frightened of those who were stronger than he. He thought it over and decided that the best thing for him to do was to become the servant of one who was stronger than anyone on earth. And he set out to find such a master. I will read the paragraph once again. Dogs were once their own masters and lived the way wolves do in freedom until a dog was born who was ill-pleased with this way of life. He was sick and tired of wandering about by himself, looking for food and being frightened of those who were stronger than he. He thought it over and decided that the best thing for him to do was to become the servant of one who was stronger than anyone on earth, and he set out to find such a master. Scientifically, dogs and wolves are of same family. Thousands of years back, man tamed wolves into dogs. This folk tale tells about how the first dog was found. Long ago, dogs were also free animals and happily roamed in the forest. They were freely roaming around the forest without any restrictions. They hunted their own food and didn't have any masters. They were not slaves, but this changed. There was one young dog who was bored of his life. He decided to find a new master. After repeated thoughts, the dog decided to be a slave or servant of an animal. But he was very particular that his master should be strongest and most powerful person in the earth, so that he could not be afraid of anyone. Children, you all are eager to know what happened next. Wait for the next class. Till then, bye bye.